collision is nothing but a sort of the collision in which there is a change in the velocity and it gets set right and they become in your common line basically. In physics, generally collision is said to happen when momentum of the one body changes due to the other body. Like say, okay. Due to the principal in a classroom, the principal is going in a corridor, all the students were making the noise. The moment they see the principal coming towards their classroom, the complete mass class will get set right. That means the mass and velocity, momentum of all the classroom is going to change with respect to the mass and velocity of the principal, sir.
Yes.
So if there is no external force in any kind of collision, beta, there is no external force acting on that one, isn't it?
Okay,
if there is no external force acting on that one, then momentum is said to be conserved. Like see, when principal is coming, isn't it? And no one is telling them to get set right. They are automatically getting. If it is a kid, means the teacher should make them to sit in a right if the principal is on a road. Like if a 10th class student is making the noise and if you see the principal has been coming, he automatically gets set right on its own.
Yes.
That means no external force has been required at that time. Got it in idea?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Isn't it? So in any kind of the collision, there will be no external force. If there is no external force, that means momentum is said to be conserved. That means when is momentum conserved and external force acting on the system is?
Zero, sir.
Zero, isn't it? So I can write the definition of the collision was better. So collision is nothing but, collision is when momentum, when momentum of one body, when momentum of your one body changes due to other body. Okay.
Sure. Yes, sir.
In any kind of collision, beta, in any kind of collision. So in our syllabus, we are having elastic collision, inelastic collision, perfectly inelastic collision, oblique collision, isn't it? So in all this type of a collision, if there is no external force, if there is no external force, then momentum is said to be conserved. Then momentum is said to be conserved. Clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
So I can say that if F external is equals to zero, external is equals to zero, that means momentum is said to be conserved. P bar is conserved. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Types of collisions. Okay. The first one is elastic collision. Second one is inelastic collision. Third one is perfectly inelastic collision. Okay. Fourth one is 1D collision. Fifth one is oblique collision or 2D collision. Okay, so these are the types of the collisions which we are going to discuss. Okay, elastic collision, inelastic collision, perfectly inelastic collision, one dimension collision, oblique collision, or also known as of your two dimension collision. There is also called as a collision called as of your super elastic collision also. Like in Deepavali, you might have been played with some bombs, which you take it and hit it to the wall. They get burst, kada.
Yes,
sir. Isn't it? That is called as if your super elastic collision, super inelastic collision, where there is a loss of your energy particulation. Clear?
Yes.
So in perfectly inelastic collision, what is happening is the body will stick to the, like say, if you might have been seen any times in the, like say, for example, in the villages. You might have been seen that a clay, a mud, they will be hitting to the walls. So they will be in the form of your vertical lines and horizontal lines. So when a clay or when a wet mud is being heated to the wall, that will stick to that one and it will get dry. When it gets dry, it will fall down.
Yes.
Isn't it? So the collision in which the body sticks to the second body immediately and both of them are moving with one common velocity. Such type of a collisions are called as of what? Perfectly inelastic.
Perfectly inelastic.
So let us try to first discuss about your elastic collision.
Sir, 2D collision is also called as oblique collision.
Oblique collision. Oblique collision. And remember one thing, beta. In all the collisions from 1 to 5, one thing is common. What is that? Momentum is conserved.
Okay, sir. Means there is no external.
There is no external. But all the collisions, there is momentum is conserved.
Sir, for super elastic, it's not right.
Everything,
sir,
everywhere if the momentum is conserved. But energy may or may not be conserved, that is a different thing again.
Okay. Means okay, like force has been applied, right, sir?
Even for the perfect elastic collision, if you are applying an external force, still the momentum is said to be conserved because work done by that one is becoming form is zero.
Okay, sir. Okay? Super elastic, sir.
So all the collisions I'm telling you, you know, 1 to 5, momentum is conserved.
Okay.
So I can say here, momentum is conserved. Momentum is conserved. That means initial kinetic energy will be equal to final kinetic energy in this one.
Yes.
That means if I'm drawing a graph with momentum versus your time, I told you it is conserved gravity, it will always be a straight line like this.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Whereas kinetic energy with respect to time. Kinetic energy with respect to time. If this is initial kinetic energy, final kinetic energy will also remain for me the same, like this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So kinetic energy of the system versus your time. This will be the given condition. Clear?
Yes.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Sure. Next one. That is inelastic collision. Even in the inelastic collision, what is conserved, beta?
Momentum
is conserved. Momentum is conserved. Momentum is conserved and initial kinetic energy will be greater than final kinetic energy.
Yes.
Okay. In the inelastic collision, initial kinetic energy will be greater than final kinetic energy. Final. So this graph is again same as momentum is conserved. Momentum with respect to time, it will be a straight line like this.
Yes.
Okay. Whereas kinetic energy is completely changing with respect to time. So this is your kinetic energy versus your T. So initial kinetic energy more and final kinetic energy is less than this. This will be some variance. Oh, no? This is initial kinetic energy. This will be your final kinetic energy. Is that clear?
Yes.
Next one is perfectly inelastic collision. In perfectly inelastic collision, brother, what is happening? Body sticks to one another and move with common velocity. Move with common velocity. Okay?
Yes.
Let's say, for example, a bullet hitting their target. Let's say this is kept on a smooth surface.
Yes.
You are hitting it with your bullet of mass small m. This is capital M. After hitting it, what happened? This block will travel certain distance.
Yes, sir.
In this one, this block bullet will embedded in this one. The total mass is capital M plus small m.
Yes.
Initially, this is moving with small v. Then the velocity of HS is zero. And this is moving with one common velocity. So yes. Initial momentum must be equal to final momentum. That is M into V plus capital M into zero must be equal to capital M plus small m into common velocity capital V.
Yes.
That means common velocity will become how much? Capital V is equals to M into V divided by capital M plus of your small m. So this will be your common velocity. Clear?
Yes.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir. Got it.
No. Next one is nothing but a pure 1D collision. 1D collision, we are having one more name better. 1D collision, or it is also known as of your head-on collision. It is also called as a what? Head-on collision. Clear?
Yes.
So now we are talking about the fourth one. So the three are over here right now. So I'm writing fourth one here. So that is nothing but of your what? 1D, or we can say it is your head-on collision. Even in this one, what is common beta?
Momentum is conserved.
Conserved. momentum is conserved. That means initial momentum will be equal to final momentum.
Yes.
Isn't it? That means velocity vector of the colliding bodies are along the line of your impact. What do you mean by line of your impact? Like, see, for example, if there is a collision between two railway compartments which are coming in opposite direction.
Yes.
They are coming with very slow speed on Gunam. Like, say, this is a railway compartment, railway track. And in this one, there is one train and there is your one train. They are coming in this direction. Isn't it? It is coming with 5 km/h and is also coming with 5 km/h. What happened? They're colliding in the front direction.
Yes,
after collision, this will try to move in backward direction. This will try to move in the backward direction. It's not a very fast impact. If it is a very fast impact, what happens? They'll get destroyed.
Yes.
Isn't it? So I'm talking about that condition right now. I hope you, I mean to understand. I hope you what I mean to tell you is understanding there. Head-on collision means in one dimension, means in a straight line only.
Yes.
You know, straight line only. Like, say, for example, if I'm having a body right now like this. Okay. And another body is somewhere here right now like this.
Only along one axis.
Yeah, one axis only basically. So this is your straight line axis.
Yes, sir.
So. All right. Like this. Okay. So, like initially, this body is having a mass m1, and this is having, say, for example, m2. And this body is moving with a velocity right now. Say, for example, this is moving with velocity v1, and this is moving with velocity v2. When there will be the collision, beta? Provided if v1 is greater than v2 only.
Greater than v2. Yes, sir.
V1 is greater than v2, then only there will be collision. If the collision is along the straight line property, this straight line is known as of your line of your contact or line of your impact. Is that clear?
Yes.
That means this is along what? Common normal?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So this one, I can say this one is your common normal. Common normal, which is passing through what?
Center. The line. Yes, the center of here.
Passing through center of mass of both bodies.
Yes, sir. Sir, now
center of mass of this one.
So now the both bodies
are normal, beta. Common normal means perpendicular to the surface. This is the surface of this one.
Yes.
Here it is 90 degrees. Anna?
Yes.
This is a block. How do you draw the normal for this one? This will be the normal, gada.
Upward. Yes.
Normal is always perpendicular to the surface, gada.
Yes, sir.
That's what here common normal. I hope you got an idea.
Okay. Yes, sir.
That is about your 1D collision. The next
sir,
one is
now what if they're in opposite, like in the same direction, sir.
They are
that's
in the same direction.
That's not
opposite direction means after colliding, what happened?
Yes,
they
will
rebound in the opposite They'll direction.
Move back. Yes.
That's
sir.
It.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Over there, we don't require.
Yeah, here it may be see, like, see, the M1 may be hitting the M2 and come to the rest. So M2 will be moving in the front direction.
Yes.
Sir. Like, see, in running.
Yes.
Isn't it? There are 2-3 people who will be giving their stick to the other person so that from there the other person will be moving in the front direction.
Yes.
Isn't it? Something like that. Clear?
Okay.
Next one. Next one is your oblique collision. Oblique collision are also known as two-dimension collision.
Yes.
The best example is carom board.
Yes.
Carom board, isn't it? So when you with the striker, when you hit the so what do you call that one coin? The coin will move in one direction. Striker will move in the other direction.
Yes, sir.
So they are in two dimension. X and Y la move atuna simultaneous ga, but they are in the one single plane only.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So this one is one striker. This one, say, for example, another coin like this. Okay, there is a collision between them. Okay, and this one is a common normal for this one. So when they strike right now, what is happening is this might be moving in this direction with one velocity v1, and this body might be moving with another velocity, like, say, for example, v2.
Yes.
And this one is known as what? Line of your impact. Is it clear?
Yes.
So even in this one, what is happening, beta? momentum is said to be conserved.
Conserved, yes.
There is initial momentum will be equal to your final momentum.
Final.
Clear?
Yes.
Let us try to go for the first one. Elastic head-on collision. Elastic head-on collision. Derivation also not there. You have board exam at all. Okay. Sir, you
have 11th board, right?
M1, what?
You have 11th board, right? Sir, you have 11th board,
right? You have confirmation.
Okay.
Let's say this one is M1 moving with U1, M2 moving with your U2.
Mm-hmm.
After collision, this M1 might be moving with velocity V1 and this M2 might be moving with velocity V2. So, momentum is conserved for both of them, beta. Initial momentum must be equal to final momentum.
Final.
Initial momentum means M1 U1 plus of your M2 U2 will be equal to your M1 V1 plus of your M2 into V2.
Yes.
So this is my equation number one. And even in this one, kinetic energy is conserved with initial kinetic energy will be equal to final kinetic energy. So this is yes, your sir. Half into M1 into U1 square plus half into your M2 into your U2 square is equals to your half into your M1 into V1 square plus half into your M2 into your V2 square.
Yes.
So, if I simplify and get the relations, we'll be getting the two important formulas in this one, but I'm directly writing the results. No need of the derivation because we are preparing for the
Liga Vati.
So, yes. It is U1 minus of your U2 is equals to your V2 minus V1. That means velocity of approach. Velocity of your approach is equals to velocity of separation.
Yes.
Velocity of your separation. Very important formula, beta. Very, very okay. Important formula. U1 minus of your U2 is equals to V2 minus of your V1. That is velocity of your approach means U1 minus U2. Velocity of separation means what? V2 minus
V2. Minus. Sir, this is not like any standard formula, right, sir? Because they're opposite.
So U1 minus U2, Gabate, I can even use the word relative?
Yes, sir.
Relative velocity of approach.
Yes.
This one is also your relative velocity of
separation.
Can I use even that word?
Yes, sir.
You're talking about in one dimension only.
Okay, sir.
You're talking about your one dimension only. So if I need to calculate V2 from this one, can you tell me what you write the V2?
Sir, V2 is equals to.
U2 will be equal to U1 minus
U2 plus.
U1 minus U2 plus V1.
Yes.
So this will be the value of V2.
Yes.
The same way we can even get the value of V1 if we need. That's not
yes, important
formula, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So after simplifying, we are getting very important formulas beta. That is V1 is equals to M1 minus of your M2 divided by M1 plus of your M2 into your U1 plus 2 times of your M2 divided by M1 plus of your M2 into your U2. Very important formula.
Okay, sir. So from what has this come, sir?
This derivation is better. Like say,
okay,
if I take this V2, substitute in equation number one.
Okay, yes, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
Just simplifying this equation 192. Simplifying this equation
okay,
192.
Yes.
We'll be getting the values of V1 and C.
Okay.
Initially, the M1 was moving with U1 and M2 was moving with U2. After collision, what is happening? M1 is getting new velocity, other V1.
Yes, sir.
And this is getting V2. So what is that V1 and V2 means? That's what we are calculating. V1 is this much.
Yes, sir.
So V2, what you do is just change the subscript there. That's it. V2 means what you will write? Just change the subscript. That means in the place of
yes,
1, you keep 2. In the place of 2, you keep 1.
1. Yes, sir.
So it is M2 minus M2 M1
minus
divided by M1 M2. Plus M2. Because it doesn't make any difference.
Yes, sir.
Your
both
of things. Plus 2 times of your M1 divided by M1 plus M2 or M2 plus M1. It will be one and the same only. No?
Yes.
This will be equal to your U1.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
This is one more important formula you need to remember.
Yes.
Okay, na?
Yes.
Very important formula. Okay. So in the perfectly inelastic collision, relative velocity of your approach will be equal to relative velocity of your separation. This is very, very important bit. U1 minus of U2 is equals to V2 minus of your V1.
Yes.
Clear? So relative velocity of your approach is equals to relative velocity of your separation. Clear?
Yes.
Let's see. If mass is a spherical beta, can I write the mass in terms of volume and density? Mass is equals to volume into density. Mass is equals to, because density is equals to mass by volume. So mass is equals to volume into density.
Yes,
if it is a similar body, volume can be written as 4 by 3 pi into your r cube into rho. 4 by 3 is a constant. Density is also constant. So mass will be directly proportional to r cube.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Why? Because 4 by 3 is a constant.
Yes, sir.
Pi is also
then a constant. Pi r, yes, sir. Pi is also. Only r cube will change.
Metal is also constant.
Yes, mass
of ball, whether the ball is 1 kg or 100 kg. If metal is same, so density will be the same. Gada?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So can I write in the place of mass now r?
Yes, sir.
That means V1 will become how much? Can I write here roughly? V1 is equals to R1 cube minus R2 cube divided by R1 cube plus of your R2 cube into your U1 plus 2 times of your how much?
R2 cube
divided by R1 cube plus of your R2 cube into your U2. Can I write like this?
Yes.
It's also same. V2. V2 will be equal to your how much for me?
R2 cube
minus of your R1 cube divided by R1 cube plus of your R2 cube into your how much for me?
U2. Sir, U1. This
one will become how much? 2 times of your, isn't it? 2 times of your R1 cube divided by R1 cube plus of your R2 cube into your
U1.
Okay, the radius less thing.
Yes.
Don't get confused.
Okay, sir.
Clear, Abida?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Any doubt?
No, sir. So this is inelastic head-on, right?
Elastic head-on collision.
Yes, sir.
This is for your elastic head-on collision part deflation. So for the elastic head-on collisions part deflation, momentum will be your conserve.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when we talk about a perfectly inelastic collision also, the formulas will be same. But we need to just remember the values in terms of your coefficient of your restitution. That I'll tell you how to remember that.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now tell me. Let me give you one small example. This is a ball of, say, for example, 2 kg. Moving with your 5 meter per second. This is your ball of your 3 kg, moving with a velocity of your 2 meter per second. After collision, if 2 kg ball is moving with velocity V1 and 3 kg ball is moving with a velocity V2. Okay, na?
Yes.
Now, can you get me the value of V1 and V2, beta? Can you get me the velocity of your V1 and V2?
Yes,
is
sir.
How much? M1 is 5 kg.
Yes, sir.
U1 is 5 meter per second.
Same side.
M2 is equals to 2 meter per second. And U2 is equals to, sorry, this is 3 kg. 3 kg.
Yes, sir. This is 2.
Is your 3 kg U2 mass. Is, this is 2 meter per second. After the collision.
Sir, M1 is 2 kg. Sir, M1 is 2.
M1 is 2 kg, sorry. By mistake, I have written.
Yes.
This one is your 2 kg. Okay. V1 is how much? M2 is still 3 kg. And V2 is how much? Can I do it?
Yes.
V1 formula is what, beta? V1 is equals to M1 minus M2, gada? M1 minus M2 divided by M1 plus of your M2 into U1 or U2?
So this is... U1, sir.
V1 is first U1.
Yes, sir.
So this is your U1 plus 2 times of what? M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into your U2. Ante na? Chudo sir. 2 times of your M2. Okay.
Yes.
So now what is M1? 2 kgs.
Yes, sir.
Minus 3 divided by 2 plus 3 into U1 is 5. Plus 2 into 3 divided by 2 plus 3 into 2. 2 minus 3 is how much?
Minus 1, sir.
Minus 1. This y will get cancelled. This is minus 1 plus. This 2, 3 is a 6. 6 by 5 into 2.
12 by 5, sir. Yes.
Isn't it? So this will be equal to minus 1 plus. This one is how much?
12 by 5.
Isn't it? Minus 1 plus 12 by 5. Now take the LCM of this one and tell me how much it will be done.
We can.
5. This is minus 5 plus 12. So this will be equal to how much?
8 by 5. Minus
5 plus 12 is how much?
8 by 5, sir.
Huh?
8 by 5.
5 plus 12.
Yes, sir.
How much?
Sir, 8 by 5, sir.
8, huh?
7, sorry.
Mari? Plus or minus?
Sir. Plus, sir.
7 by 5.
Yes.
Meter per second. Clear, huh?
Yes.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Chinda?
Yes, sir. V2 chain.
V2?
Yes.
V2 is equal to what? I can write the formula? Just opposite of
M2 minus...
M2 minus M1 divided by 1 plus M2 into your
into U2
plus 2 times plus of two your M1, M1 divided by M1 plus of your M2 into your U1.
Yes.
Isn't it? So now write that value. So that will be equal to your M2 value is how much beta? 3 minus 2 divided by 3 plus 2 is 5. U2 is how much beta? 2. Plus 2 times of M1. M1 is nothing but 2 divided by 5 into. This one is how much for me? 5.
Yes, sir.
This 5 will get cancelled.
Yes.
3 minus 2 is how much for me?
1, sir.
1. That means 2 by 5.
2 by 5. Plus 4.
4
by 5.
4 by 5. 5 cancel.
5 by 5.
It's been gone right now. So that will be equal to how much for me? LCM is your 5.
22 by.
How much for me? 2
plus
20. That means 22 divided by 5 meter per second. Is that clear?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Pakka na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. We'll do the numericals later, beta.
Okay, sir.
If masses are same now, what happens? You tell me. If M1 is equal to your M2, what happens to the V1 and V2?
Sir, V1, sir, like the first part will become V1. 0.
Yeah, M1 and M1, 0.
0, yes, sir.
Isn't it? Then M2?
Only right side would be there, sir. Only
This will be 2M2. M2 means M. So this one is M plus M, 2M. 2M, 2M gets cancelled, it will become U2?
Yes, sir.
So V1 will become for me how much? U2?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Sure. The same way, what will be the V2?
V2 also
will
be equal
to V2 here, it is M2 minus M. That is nothing but equal to M minus M, 0.
Yes, sir.
So U2
U1,
is
one, sir.
This is 2M. That means it will become for me U1.
Yes.
So V2 will become for me U1. So what you did understood from this one? If two similar bodies are colliding, they will be exchanging their velocities. V1 is becoming U2 and U2 is V and V2 is becoming for me U1.
Yes, sir.
Onagada?
Yes, sir.
One more condition. This is a case number one. Now, case number two. In the same condition, if M1 is much, much greater than of your M2 and U2 is at your rest, that means second body is at your rest condition.
Yes, sir.
Second body is at your rest condition. M2 is very, very greater. Or else you can take M1, no problem. Here I'm taking right now. M2 is much greater than M1.
Means M1 we can neglect, sir.
Yeah. So when M2 is much, much greater than M1, we can neglect the value of your M1, gada?
Yes.
At the time, V1 will become how much for me, beta? V1 will be equal to your... V1 M1 will be minus. Equal to your how much? M1 minus of your M2?
Yes, sir. Which is minus M2, minus M2, sir.
Minus?
Ante, in the numerator, sir, M1 minus M2 will become minus M2, right, sir?
U2 rest low on the gada.
Yes. Okay, zero.
That means second body is becoming zero.
Zero, yes.
Because U2 into multiplied anything will become zero.
Yes.
Now, if I'm writing this value of M1 minus M2, M2
yes, is much minus than M2,
M1, but M1 can be neglected in this one?
Minus M2,
yes. Isn't it? Yeah. So what is happening right now? Minus of U1, Asunda?
Yes, sir.
So V1 will
cancel.
Minus of your U1.
Yes.
The same way V2. V2 will become how much? See that?
Minus of U2.
V2 is equals to. And V2 also, M2 is much, much greater.
Yes, sir.
M1 can be neglected.
Plus U2.
Sir. Isn't it? So any of this will become zero for the first one?
Yes,
so
sir.
M1 is neglected.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Zero divided so by anything will be what?
Infinity, sir.
Huh?
Zero divided by. Sorry.
Infinity,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Zero. So become how much? Zero.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
If second body is much, much, much greater than the first body, and U2 is at your rest.
Yes.
So if the heavier body hits the smaller body, what happened? Smaller body will get a more velocity, and if a heavier body will come back to the rest.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
It'll stop. Yes, sir.
Like, say, for example, this is, say, for example, a wall. Like this. Wall is at your rest.
Yes.
Now, if you are hitting a ball with a velocity of 2 meter per second, what happens? Will the wall move?
No, sir.
No, brother. So, what happened to the ball?
So, the ball will come and stop and...
Why ball will come and stop it? If you take a ball
rebound,
and hit to the wall, will stop
it.
Will rebound, brother. So, this ball will come in the backward direction with the same velocity. That is nothing but 2 meter per second. That's what the minus sign indicates here. V1 is equals to your minus of your U1. Like, see, if U1 is 2 meter per second, after collision, what is U1 and minus 2 rasa masa direct ga? What an idea?
Yes,
what an idea?
Yes, sir.
And what is the velocity of the wall?
So,
like, see, here M1 is right now ball, M2 is the wall.
Yes.
There is a collision between the ball and as well as of your wall. Now, wall is acting as M2.
This ball is much larger. Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Now M2 is always at rest. That means U2 is zero.
Yes, sir.
After collision also, the wall is at rest. So V2 is zero only.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? But V1 is becoming how much for me? Opposite direction. Minus 2 meter per second.
Minus.
See what I have taken right now. V1 is minus of U1.
Minus.
And V2 is becoming for me zero.
Yes,
when second body is more larger compared to the first body. Got an idea?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And third one. Opposite of this one. If I say that M1 is much, much greater than of your M2 and U2 is at your rest, like a lorry hitting a car.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Like a lorry, like say, for example, this is a larger body and it has been hit by a smaller body like now here.
Yes.
This one is your M1, this is your M2, and this body is moving with initial velocity U1, and this body is initial velocity U2 is zero. So
yes.
after the collision, the first body will get a velocity right now.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So the first body M1 will get a new velocity that is nothing but V1. And the second body, what happened to the second body? What happens to the second body? So this second body will get a velocity of V2. Anna?
Yes.
Now tell me logically which velocity will be more, V1 or V2?
So V2, sir.
V2, because when a lorry is hitting a two-wheeler or a car, it will go more distance ahead, gada.
Yes.
Isn't it? So right now I can write here, V1 will be equal to, isn't it? U2
yes.
is rest. U2 is rest, V1 formula. V1 formula.
Yes, sir.
In this term will completely will become zero.
Yes, sir.
So in this one, M1 is much, much greater than M2. That means M2 can be neglected.
Yes, sir.
So M2 is neglected means M1 by M1 into U1. So, MM gets cancelled. So, V1 will become how much? U1?
U1, yes.
So, V1 will become for me U1. What happens to V2? Now, see the formula. V2 formula, you see? V2, where is this one? V2. V2 is this one. U2 is rest property. This is completely zero.
Yes, sir.
So, M1 is much, much greater property. This is neglected.
Yes.
So this M1 gets cancelled. So, it is two times
of U1. Yes, sir. 2U1.
Ramendra?
Yes, sir.
Two times of U1?
U1.
So V2 will become for me two times of U1. That means velocity of the smaller body will be twice the velocity of the larger body.
Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Isn't it? Like say for example, if there is a lorry and this lorry is hitting a two-wheeler. or cyclist, something like this.
Yes.
And this is, say, for example, a lorry is, say, for example, 100 kgs. And this one is, like, say, for example, 50 kgs.
Yes.
Okay. And this one is at rest. Papa.
Yes.
The cycle is at your rest. This is lorry. And this one is your cycle. And the lorry is moving with, say, for example, 100 meter per second.
Yes.
What happens after collision?
The cycle
after collision, the lorry velocity will be, that means V1 is becoming how much for me? U1, because this is
U1. Yes.
After hitting, lorry will get a V1. V1 is nothing but U1 only. That is how much? 100 meters.
100 meters.
There is no change in that one.
Yes.
What happens to the cyclist?
200 meters.
Isn't it? That will be moving with what velocity? 200 meters 200 per second. Meters. At a very huge speed, so that will be falling in the front direction.
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Is that logic clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sure, fine. Very good. Tell the answer for this question.
Yes.
Say, for example, a ball is moving with velocity, is moving with velocity 2 meters per second towards a heavy wall. Towards a heavy wall, moving towards the ball with a speed 1 meter per second. Okay, as
yes,
shown
sir.
In figure. Assuming collision to be elastic. Assuming collision to be elastic, find the velocity of the ball immediately after the collision.
Yes.
Immediately after the collision. Can you try? I'll give this.
Sir, so U1 is 2 meters per second.
This is your wall. First read the question carefully. Okay, this is your wall. And this is your ball. This ball is moving with 2 meters per second. This wall is moving with your 1 meter per second.
Yes.
Okay. Wall is not at rest now.
Yes.
Wall is at not rest and it is moving in opposite direction. So take care of your sign convention also. First
yes.
option is 1 meter per second. Second option is 2 meter per second. Third option is 3 meter per second. Fourth option is 4 meter per second. What is the question? A ball is moving with velocity 2 meters per second towards a heavy wall, moving towards the ball with a speed of 1 meter per second as shown in figure. Assuming
yes.
the collision to be an elastic, that means momentum is conserved.
Yes.
If momentum is conserved, you know how to calculate the velocity of the ball after the collision.
Yes.
Velocity of the ball after the collision means what? V1 only, na?
Yes, sir.
So V1 will be equal to M1 minus EM2 divided by M1 plus EM2 into, this one is
U1.
What? U1 or U2?
U1. U1, sir.
U1, na?
U1 yes,
plus 2 times of
two
your
times
M2
of
divided by
M1
plus M2 into your U2.
Yes.
Now, what is M1? A ball is moving with a velocity. Ball is moving with a velocity 2 meter per second towards a heavy ball, moving towards the ball with a speed of 1 meter per second. Isn't it?
Yes.
Nothing information is given related to the mass.
Yes.
Isn't it? So, mass of the first body will be equal to how much? Small m.
Okay, yes,
this one is a larger body, capital M.
Yes, yes.
Isn't it? Now see, if I'm writing this relation, this is your small m minus of your capital M divided by small m plus of your capital into U1. U1 is moving with what velocity? 2 meter per second.
Yes. That's
2 into M2 is capital M divided by small m plus of your capital M into, this is moving with what velocity? Minus 1 meter per second. Why minus? Because it
opposite
is moving with negative x-axis.
Yes.
Isn't it? Now think and tell me, what will be small m minus capital M?
Small m
ball
minus
is the larger body, Gada?
Yes, sir.
Ball is nothing but what? A small body?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Heavy ball means capital M is much greater than small m and Ardham Ikada?
Yes, sir.
That means what? We can neglect the small m?
Yes, sir.
So if I'm neglecting the small m, this will be minus m divided by your capital M into your 2. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Ardham Inda?
Yes, sir. Ardham, sir.
See, small m is like 2 kg and
it's basically
ball will be some like 100 kgs. Like if you take yes, a ball sir, and playing with the ball.
Yes, sir. I got it, sir. It's negligible.
Okay. Very good. Plus 2 times of your capital M. Here it will be equal to how much? Capital M into minus. Yes. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So this capital M, this capital M, this capital M, this capital M will get. Why I am given this problem? The students will get confused here. Array masses are not given how to apply the mass ganan.
Yes, sir. Yes.
The logic so should come basically in your mind because you are hitting very small body with a heavy body.
Yes, sir. Isn't so we have to neglect the smaller body's mass.
Obviously, right? That's what the cases what I have been told you in the above.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that neglecting nikikada body, but you need to understand that this is a huge case because if you, when you are playing with a small rubber ball in your home also, like a football also in your home. When you take your football and hit to the wall in your room, will the wall will fall down?
No, sir.
No, you may be falling down if the ball is hitting you. Onagada.
Yes, sir.
But at the time, what is the mass? Whose mass is more? Wall or ball?
Sir, the wall, sir.
Wall, so the ball mass of the ball is very small in front of that one?
Yes.
Like say if the wall is say like 100 kgs, your ball may be hardly some 50 grams or 100 grams.
Yes, sir.
Or maybe 500 grams in front of 100 kgs. 50 gram, 100 gram is almost a negligible. Gada.
Yes, sir.
That logic we need to apply here. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
This is minus 2. This one is your minus 2. So that will be equal to how much? Minus 4 meter per second. What an idea?
Yes, sir.
Ochinda?
Yes, sir. Ochinda, sir.
So minus 1 indicates in the direction.
Opposite.
The ball will be coming backward with the velocity of what? 4 meter per second.
Yes, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No,
is
sir.
It out in this one? No. Sure. Next one and very important topic, that is concept of coefficient of restitution. Concept of coefficient of restitution represented by letter E.
Okay.
So now what is this coefficient of restitution means? Small e is equals to, this is known as of your relative velocity, the ratio of relative velocity of your separation, relative velocity of your separation divided by relative velocity of your approach.
Okay, sir.
Okay, relative velocity of your approach. This is your coefficient of restitution.
So basically, it means V2 minus V1 by
U1 minus V2. Yeah, so can I write it mathematically? E is equals to V2 minus V1 divided by U1 minus U2. That's what?
Yes.
This is the coefficient of restitution. Okay?
Yes, sir.
See, this is a very important point. E value is equals to 1 for your elastic collision.
Yes.
And for inelastic collision, E value is 0. For inelastic collision, E value is 0.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So for inelastic collision, E value is equals to 0 for deflection. Is that clear for you?
Yes, sir.
That means if I take the E value to be 1 for elastic collision, then V2 minus V1 is equals to U1 minus U2.
Yes.
Any doubt in that one?
No, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Nothing, brother?
No, sir. So basically, after the class, sir, means like I'm going through the notes and up to ask me, no, sir, because I'm not able to like write and concentrate on that. I'm not able to do that, sir.
I'm going to do that, sir. I'm going to do that, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. అంటే నేను కెమిస్ట్రీ క్లాస్ కూడా అట్లనే చేస్తా సార్. అంటే
నీకు మళ్ళీ టైం వేస్ట్ అవుతుంది కదా, ఇంకేం మళ్ళీ నువ్వు రాయాలా, మళ్ళీ ఇది చేయాలి అంటే మచ్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ టైం అవునా కదా.
ఎస్ సార్, విల్ ట్రై టు లైక్ రైట్ ఫాస్ట్.
ఎందుకంటే నేను కూడా రాస్తున్నాను కదా, సో జస్ట్ రైట్ టు లిసన్ ఇట్ అండ్ ట్రై టు రైట్ ఇట్. ఇఫ్ యూ ఆర్ మిస్సింగ్ ఎనీథింగ్ యూ కెన్ జస్ట్ మేక్ షూర్ దట్ యూ కెన్ రైట్ దట్ వన్ ఆఫ్టర్ వర్డ్స్.
ఓకే,
నాట్ ఎన్ ఇష్యూ బేసికల్లీ. Okay.
Yes, sir. I'll leave some pages and I'll write from.
Yeah. So now we have been clear with your elastic head-on collisions and the formulas related to that one.
Yes, sir.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Is there any loss of the kinetic energy in this one, beta, in the elastic collision? There is no loss in the elastic collision. Avana kada?
Yes, sir.
In the head-on collision, initial kinetic energy will be equal to your final kinetic energy.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and whenever you are moving in the rightward, you take positive. Opposite direction when you are moving, you take it as if you are negative.
Negative. Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now next one is of your head-on inelastic collision, or maybe your after collision, the both the bodies are been moving with one common velocity is part of relation, and we'll be writing the coefficient of restitutions also for that given conditions.
Yes.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Next slide, reading with you. Completely head-on inelastic collision. Okay.
Yes.
Completely head-on inelastic collision is perfectly inelastic collision.
Okay, sir.
Or perfectly inelastic collision. Okay, na?
Yes.
So for the perfectly inelastic collision, what is the condition I told you, beta? After the collision, the body will stick to the another body and
yes.
try to move with one common velocity. If this
yes.
is the first body, and this one is your second body.
Yes.
Isn't it? After collision, the first body and second body will collide, will stick to each other and move with one common velocity.
Yes.
Like this.
Yes.
Isn't it? So first body is moving with a velocity of your how much beta? This is moving with u1. This is
yes.
moving with velocity u2. This is your m1. This is your m2. This is your m1 plus of your m2. And the total body is moving with a common velocity. That is nothing but of your capital V.
Yes, sir.
So there is a loss of your kinetic energy. Momentum is conserved. But initial momentum must be equal to final momentum.
Final.
I told you
yes.
m1 u1 plus of your m2 u2 will be equal to your m1 plus m2 into your common velocity. That is common V.
Yes.
So capital V will be equal to your m1 u1 plus of your m2 u2 divided by your m1 plus of your m2.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is the value of your V, common velocity. Clear?
Yes.
So common velocity is equals to your m1 u1 plus of your m2 u2 divided by your m1 plus of your m2 part of equation.
Yes. Sir. Yes, sir.
Now, is the kinetic energy conserved in this one, beta?
No. Yes, sir. Oh, kinetic energy is not, sir. Only momentum.
See, I told you in the
yes,
in the inelastic collision. And in the perfect inelastic collision, initial kinetic energy will be more compared to the final kinetic energy.
Final. Yes,
they're yes. If you are running, if you are catching a running bus,
yes, sir.
Bus already final started.
Is,
you will run
yes,
with a lot speed and try to catch the bus.
Yes, sir. After
you
that,
you enter into the bus. What is your velocity?
Very less.
Less zero, gada, because you almost
yes.
have come to the rest.
Come to rest, yes.
So your final energy will be very, very less. That means
yes.
initially you will be having more kinetic energy, and afterwards it will be very less.
Yes.
Isn't it? So there will be certain loss of kinetic energy in this one.
Okay.
So the loss in kinetic energy is calculated by loss in kinetic energy will be always be equal to what beta? Delta K. This delta K will be equal to K initial minus K final.
K final. Yes. So here.
Also, in this beta, is a waste of time for you. If you need, I can do the derivation, but literally it is of no use.
Okay.
So the final relation, what you need to remember is half into m1 into your m2 divided by your m1 plus of your m2 into u1 plus of your u2 whole square. So this is the loss in kinetic energy formula.
Okay.
The more you practice, the more you write, you will remember this formula very easily. So loss in kinetic energy will be equal to, do you want me to prove?
Yes, sir.
Proof chayana?
Yes, sir. And a half.
Enana?
Half m1 and we have to...
Yeah, then kinetic energy, this one is half into m1 into u1 square.
Yes.
Then kinetic energy half into m2 into u2 square. Then kinetic energy half into m1 plus of your m2
okay.
into
yes,
common
sir.
Velocity v square.
Yes,
this sir. Common velocity you need to substitute here.
Okay, sir.
And do the calculations.
Okay, sir.
Okay, and if you do it,
okay.
you will be getting this relation.
Got it, yes.
It is of no use, basically.
Yes.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what is the coefficient of restitution I told you, beta? E is equals to relative velocity of your separation divided by relative velocity of your approach.
Approach, yes.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Next one is, if I'm talking about your inelastic, or we can say partial, or we can say partial inelastic collision. Partial inelastic collision, which is again head on. That means okay. On a straight line.
Yes, sir.
Head on collision.
Yes, sir.
Okay, partial inelastic collision. So in this one, loss in kinetic energy is calculated by very important formula, but a very, very, very important formula. Loss in kinetic energy will be equal to same formula like above. So it is your half into M1 into your M2 divided by M1 plus of your M2. Ikkada varu common. Into here it will be equal to U1 minus of U2 whole square into 1 minus of your E square.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the formula you need to remember for this
one. Yes, sir.
The more you practice, the more better you can remember. This is yes, very sir. Important formula for the inelastic head-on collision. For the inelastic head-on collision, loss in kinetic energy will be equal to. If it is elastic collision, ando, apre mai potandi?
Sir, all the
E value will become how much?
Both are equal.
For elastic collision? One?
Zero. Yes, sorry. One.
For inelastic collision, it is zero.
It is zero.
For elastic collision, E value is one. So if I keep value one here, one minus one is how much?
Zero, sir.
Zero. Zero multiplied in this one.
Everything will become zero. Zero.
So what is the loss in kinetic energy in elastic collision?
Zero, sir.
Zero. There is no loss in kinetic energy.
Yes, sir. Because of initial and final mass.
Yeah. So that's what I can write here.
Yes.
So for elastic collision, for elastic collision, E value is how much? One. So
yes, there is kinetic energy is also
of kinetic energy. So initial kinetic energy must be equal to kinetic failure. Okay.
Yes, yes.
For completely inelastic collision. Completely inelastic collision. E value will become how much?
Zero, sir.
E value will be equal to how much? For the inelastic, completely inelastic collision. For inelastic collision, E value is zero.
Yes.
E value is zero.
Zero, yes.
Isn't it? So for the completely inelastic collision, what is the value of your E?
Sir, it's zero, right, sir?
E value will be zero. That means what is happening to the loss? There is a maximum loss of your kinetic energy.
Yes, sir, because the whole equation.
There will be the maximum loss of kinetic energy.
Yes, sir.
Maximum loss of your kinetic energy. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, inelastic collision ranges in between beta.
Sir.
If the inelastic collision, if I am taking.
Yes, sir.
Zero lesser than E, E lesser than one.
There yes.
will be loss of kinetic energy.
Okay.
Okay, no?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any other doubt in this one?
No, sir.
So these are the basic things you need to remember for elastic collision and for the completely inelastic collisions part of relation.
Yes. Sir.
Any doubt in this one?
No, sir.
Paka?
Yes, sir.
Let me give you one small question on this one. A particle charging on the equipment. Sure, yeah. A particle of mass m. Okay?
Yes.
A particle of mass m moving with some velocity. Moving with some velocity on a smooth surface. On a smooth surface. Strikes another particle of mass neta times of your m. Very important model.
Yes.
3-4 times revise cheyala kachithanga.
Yes. Sir.
Neta times of your m at your rest. Okay. Elastically head on. elastically head on. Now the question is, what fraction of incident kinetic energy is transferred to the particle of mass neta times of your m? So first try to understand the question. We got a particle of mass m which is moving with what velocity beta? Is moving with some velocity on a smooth surface. Like say this is a particle of mass of your m and moving with a velocity of your u. There is your another particle of mass of your how much beta? Neta times of your m. And this one is moving with what velocity? Strikes another particle of mass neta m, which is at rest. Which is at rest and u2 will become for me zero.
Yes.
After collision, the first body is been moving with a velocity of your m. This is moving with a velocity of your how much? V1. And this is a particle of mass how much for me? Neta m.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And this one is right now neta times of your m.
Yes.
The velocity of v2.
Yes, sir.
Now, what type of a collision it is? Elastic head-on collision.
Yes.
So I told you in all the collision, what is conserved? Momentum.
Momentum is conserved.
So initial momentum must be equal to final momentum.
Yes.
M into your u plus neta into m into your zero must be equal to your m into v1 plus neta times of your m into v2. Can I write like this?
Yes.
So this will become how much for me beta? Everywhere masses are same. So this mass, this is totally zero. This m will get cancelled.
Yes.
U is equals to V1 plus neta times of V2.
V2. Yes.
Onagada.
Yes.
So that is a given relation right now. And then?
Yes.
Then what is the neta relation right now? Velocity. What type of collision it is?
Elastic head-on, sir.
Elastic head-on. Elastic collision E value is how much? E is equals to V2 minus V1 divided by U1 minus U2.
Yes.
Elastic collision E value?
1, sir.
1. That means V2 minus V1 will become how much? V2 minus V1 will become how much for me?
U1 minus 0. U2. Okay, U2 is 0, yes.
Anagada?
Yes.
Now, what is the value of V2 and danger soak? So it is your right now?
U1 plus?
V2 will be equal to how much for me?
Sir, U1 plus V1, sir.
V2 will be equal to? U1 is nothing but? U. That means it will become for me V1 plus U?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes.
This is my equation number 2. Isn't it? This is my equation number 1. So from that one I can get the value of V2?
Yes, sir.
So now what you'll do, substitute 2 in your 1. So U is equals to V1 plus neta into this one is V1 plus neta into V2. Can I write like this?
Yes, sir.
So this will become how much for me? U is equals to V1 plus neta into V1 plus neta square into V2.
V2. Yes.
And then?
Yes.
Am I doing any mistake here? Why neta times beta? Neta times gada. V1 neta times V1 plus U gada.
V1 plus? Yes, sir. Second equation. Yes. Sir.
Second equation.
Second in one.
Two is V1 plus neta times of your V2. V2 is how much? V1 plus U. Gada. V1 plus U.
Okay. Yes, sir.
V1 plus of your U.
V2 lo, yes, sir. V2 is, yes, sir. V1 plus
V1 U. V1 plus of your ikkada U. Avala.
Ikkada kuda, yes.
So, neta into V1. So, this will become for me neta into your U.
U. Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Now yes, I can get the value of V1 from this one?
Yes, sir.
Or else I need the value of V2. Kabatti. I can substitute the value of U also in this one directly. I'll do one thing. Because I need final velocity. Kabatti. So what I'll do is, I'll substitute 1 in your 2. So I'll directly get V2 value. V2 is equals to V1 plus U value is how much I got?
V1 plus neta V2, sir.
V1, U value is how much?
V1 plus neta.
V1 plus neta times of?
V2.
Now yes. All the V2 terms I can take on one side?
Yes, sir.
So how much it is?
V2 minus Nita V2 is equals to 2V1.
V2 minus Nita times of V2 is equals to?
2V1, sir.
2V1. There?
Yes, sir. V2 common.
If I take V2 common, this is 1 minus Nita is equals to 2 times of V1.
Yes, so V2 is equals to
2 times of V1 divided by 1 minus
Nita. 1 minus Nita. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And V1 value is how much beta? V1 value, if I can write from this relation.
So V1 is equals to V2 minus U1, right, sir?
Okay, anything I can get, no problem. Okay, now what do we need right now? Kinetic energy of the particle of mass M will be equal to how much beta? Kinetic energy of particle of mass Nita times of your M. That will be equal to your half into m into v square. So m will be equal to how much for me? Nita times of your m into your v2 square. Can I write like that? And initial kinetic energy will be equal to how much? Half into m into your u square. Okay, no?
Yes.
Now, fraction of, what is asking the problem? Fraction of incident kinetic energy which is transferred to Nita times of your M. How much? That means kinetic energy of Nita particles, that is half into Nita into M into your V2 square divided by half into M into your U square. Half of gets cancelled, M gets cancelled. So that will be equal to Nita into your V2 square divided by your U square.
Yes.
Okay. Isn't it?
Yes.
So that will be equal to Nita into, this is Nita into, this is for me V2 square and this one is also U square. So this one is U square. Okay.
Yes.
Now, I need to get the V2 in terms of your U only because V1 I got there. So can I write that one in terms of U beta? This one is 2 times. V1 is how much beta from equation number 1? From equation number 2, sorry.
So V1 is V2 minus U, sir.
V2 minus
U, sir.
U divided by 1 minus Nita. That means this is 2 times of V2 minus 2 times of U divided by 1 minus Nita.
Yes.
All the V2 terms I can take on one side beta?
Yes.
If I hear right now. This 2V2 if I take on other side, that will be equal to how much? V2 together?
Yes, sir.
Minus V2, huh?
Yes, sir, minus V2, sir.
Minus minus will get cancelled. So V2 will become for me 2 times of U divided by.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. Yes, sir, minus minus will get cancelled. True, sir.
This one is V2. This 2V2 take inside, this will become how much?
Minus 2V2, sir.
Minus 2V2.
Yes, sir.
That is equals to minus of minus U 2. Divided by 1 minus Nita.
Yes, sir. We can write this as minus 2V2 plus
V2 comma 1 minus 2 is equals to minus 2U divided by 1 minus Nita.
Yes, sir.
1 minus 2 is how much?
Minus 1.
Minus
V2.
V2 is equals to minus of 2U divided by 1 minus Nita.
Minus
V2 is equals to 2 mu divided by 1 minus Nita.
Yes, sir.
Am I doing anywhere calculation mistake?
Sir, from here we were right, sir. Actually, right. Correct, sir. Huh? Correct,
sir. I think this will become plus, sir. V2. V1 is how much, sir? V1 is equals to. From equation 2. From equation 2, what is V1?
Sir, V2 minus U, right, sir?
V2 minus U, right?
Yes, sir.
So if I'm opening that bracket, 2V2 minus 2U, that is equals to 1 by Nita. Then,
yes, sir.
Am I doing any calculation mistake, you say that?
Sir, it's right, sir.
Correct, sir?
Yes, sir, correct.
Okay. So that will become for me fraction here, neta, then V2 by U. So I can write from here V2 by U. V2 by U is how much for me? 2 by 1 minus neta.
Yes.
So this is your 2 by 1 minus of neta whole square. That means that will become for me 4 times of your neta divided by 1 minus of neta whole square. Got it?
Yes.
Am I doing anything mistake? I don't know.
Sir, but
initial momentum is, say for example, m into u, neta into your m is 0. That is m into v1. Then velocity of your approach. Here u, I'm getting it as of your v1 plus neta times of your u2. Because masses are same for me. Okay, that is clear. Yes. Then also, I have written here right now one term, coefficient of restitution. What type of collision it is, beta?
Elastic.
Down collision, kabadi, e value is same. That means relative velocity of approach will be equal to relative velocity of separation. U2 is 0. V2 minus V1 is equals to U1. So V2 will become for me. This one is minus. This one is minus will go here. That will become for me U plus V1. Gada. U1 is U. U plus V1. Gada. Does it make any difference?
It's same, right? So U plus V1 or V1 plus U.
So, if I am writing this u plus v1, let me check it out. Does it make any difference? U1 is nothing but u. This one will become for plus v1. This is your equation number 2. Okay?
Yes.
So, v2 I got correct, beta. V2 is equals to how much for me? V2 is equal substituting 1 in your 2. Substituting equation number 1 in your 2. 2 is what for me? Yes.
It will be same, sir.
Yeah, plus V2. So it is U plus of V1. V1 and the Chandanaku. V1 is equals to U is equals to, I can substitute here, V1 plus neta times of V2 plus V1. It doesn't make any much difference, brother.
Yes, sir.
Sure,
yes, sir.
Let me check it out once. Collisions, this is only the problem. We have a lot of calculations in this one.
Yes.
V2 value is equal to how much I got? V2 value is nothing but of your U plus V1. U value is here how much? V1 plus neta times of your V2. Antena?
Yes.
So of your V1. So this is your V1 plus neta times of V2 plus of your V1. This is V2. So I need to take the V2 outside. So if I open this bracket, this will become for me V1 plus neta times of V2. This will become for me plus V1. Can I write like this?
Yes, sir.
If I take this term here right now, this will become how much? V2 minus, gada?
Yes, sir.
Minus neta times of your V2 is equals to, this one will become for me 2 times of V1.
Yes.
Isn't it? So from this one, I can get the value of V2. V2 will be 1 minus neta. That is equals to 2 times of V1. So V2 will be equal to 2 times of V1 divided by 1 minus neta. Then?
Yes.
Sure. Now, if there is any calculation mistake, you can recheck it later.
Okay.
Clear?
Yes.
So that was about your coefficient of your restitution concepts related relations for this one, basically. And the same concept you can apply even for your all the given conditions. Like say, sometimes they'll be asking us to calculate the coefficient of your restitutions, kinetic energy, blah, blah conditions also, you can simplify from this one. Let me give you one more example. Like say, for example, elastic collision problems. A ball strikes directly upon another ball at rest. Okay. Is
yes.
itself reduced to rest by the impact. By the impact. If half of the initial kinetic energy. Half of the initial kinetic energy is lost in collision. Find the value of E. Find the value of your E.
Yes.
Okay. Now, what type of a collision it is? You tell me first. A ball strikes directly upon another ball which is at your wrist. That means this is your ball of mass M1. So this is your ball of mass of your M2. That means this one is at rest gravity, U2 will be equal to zero. And this is moving with U1. U1 is equals to U, isn't it? After collision, M1 is getting a velocity. It is coming to the rest. Isn't it? If the half of the initial kinetic energy has been lost, find the value of E. Ball strikes directly upon another body at rest, is itself reduced to rest another. And V1 is coming to be zero. And this is your M2. M2 is moving with the velocity of V2. This V2 is equals to how much?
Okay. Sir, V2 is equal to...
Momentum is conserved together?
Yes, sir.
So, momentum is conserved and initial momentum must be equal to final momentum?
Yes.
So, it is M1 into your U plus M2 into 0 will be equal to your M1 into 0 plus of your M2 into your V2. Avana?
Yes, sir.
So, that means this will become for me M1 into your U will be equal to your M2 into your V2. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is my equation number one. What type of collision is it? Elastic or inelastic?
Sir, it's coming to rest, right, sir? And yes.
Half of the initial kinetic energy is lost. There is some loss of energy. So, obviously, it
will inelastic. Yes, sir.
It will not be an elastic. So, it will be an inelastic.
Because there is a change
in kinetic energy. Minus of V1 divided by U1 minus of U2.
Yes,
sir. Isn't it?
What
is at rest? V1 is at rest. That means V2, V2 minus 0 divided by U1 is U and U2 is also 0. So, E is equal to how much I'm getting? But E is equals to?
0, sir.
V2
minus. We have to find. Yes, sir. Yes.
So, V2 is how much for me? E times of your U?
Yes, sir.
This is my equation number 2. Isn't it? So, from 1 and 2. What I can get from 1 and 2.
So, V2 we can write it as M1 U by M2. Right?
Yeah, so I can write here M1 U is equals to M2 into V2 is E times U.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So, what is getting cancelled in this one? This U,
U and U.
Cancels. M1 is equals to your
M2
times of your E.
E is equals to M1 by M2.
Now, what is asking the problem? If half of the initial kinetic energy is lost, that means loss in kinetic energy is how much? Half of the initial.
Yes,
loss
sir.
Means half delta K. Delta K is half of your initial kinetic energy.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the kinetic loss in kinetic energy formula? Half into M1 into M2 divided by M1 plus of your M2 into your. This will become how much for me, beta? U1 minus of your U2 whole square into one minus of your E whole square is equals to half into kinetic energy is half into M1 into your U square.
Yes, sir.
Initial kinetic energy and it.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Initial kinetic energy will be equal to how much for me? Half into M1 into your U square.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Now, is anything getting cancelled there, you see, beta?
Sir,
this half will get cancelled.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? M1 is equal to how much for me, beta? E times of your M2 into E into your M2 divided by M2 into E plus of your M2 into U1. U2 is how much for me? Zero?
And yes, sir.
U2 is zero, not true. U2 is here zero. So, that into 1 minus of your E square is equals to half into M1 is equals to how much for me? M2 into your E into your U square. And then,
yes, sir.
Anything is getting cancelled? U1 is nothing but U only, no?
Yes, sir. U square, once it becomes.
U square and this U square will get cancelled?
Yes,
sir. M2E will get cancelled?
Yes.
Isn't it? So, this will become for me M2 divided by 1 plus E into your M2 into 1 minus of your E square. And then,
yes, sir.
That is equals to 1 by 2. Any doubt?
No, sir.
So now what I can write here right now in this one? This M2 also get cancelled?
Yes, sir.
This is how much for me now? 1 minus E square
pi
1 plus of your E is equals to 1 by 2.
Yes.
Isn't it? So this will become how much for me, beta? 1 minus of your E square. Into what, Nidhi?
1 plus E by 2, right?
1 plus?
E by 2.
1 plus E by 2, huh?
Yes, sir. 1 minus E square is equals to 1 plus E by 2.
1 plus?
E by 2. 1 plus E by 2.
And 1 minus E also. 1 plus E will get cancelled here?
Yes, sir.
1 minus of your E square divided by this one is nothing but how much for me? 1 plus E. Antena?
Yes, sir.
Is 1 minus E square is equals to 1 plus E divided by 2. Antena?
Yes,
sir. So it is 2 minus 2 E square is equals to 1 plus E. All the E terms you take on one side? Minus 2?
Yes, sir.
This is how much you are getting? Minus 2e square. Can't take like that, no?
We can't. Sir.
So this will be 2 common. 1 minus of your e square is equals to 1 plus e. Adi osin malana.
Yes.
One minus e square can be written as of your one plus e into one minus e.
Yes, sir.
Oh no, the one plus e will get cancelled. We cut it just so I can simplify here itself. So this will become for me one minus of your e. Sorry, this also will go. Sorry. Here itself I can write 1 minus e square divided by 1 plus e and this one will be written as of your 1 plus e into 1 minus e. 1 plus e, 1 yes. plus e will get cancelled. So 1 minus e will be equal to 1 by 2. So e will become how much for me? 1 by 2.
Yes.
So e value will become for me 1 by 2. Got it? Is it clear?
Yes.
So this is also one of the important model beta. So keep it as star mark for this question also and try to practice this question. And this question directly you can make it as a shortcut and try to do it out twice and thrice part affiliation. This question that will be helpful for your doing of your numericals. Okay, no?
Yes.
You have maths class, no? Sorry, chemistry class.
Chemistry, yes.
Oblique collisions, we'll try to do it in the tomorrow session of the class.
Okay.
Late varaku anukunnanu nenu class actual anno 7:30 varaku anno.
Yes.